there are heavy clashes in the Donetsk settlement of Pesky. Ukraine's forces went on the offensive there yesterday, but were unsuccessful in capturing the settlement. Kyiv is using mortars, cannon artillery, battle tanks and other military equipment there. Furthermore, Ukrainian forces have attacked Donetsk airport and the settlement of Spartak, where Novorossian battalions Vostok, Sparta and Somali hold positions. During the day of clashes, 23 Novorossian warriors were wounded and 3 armored vehicles were damaged. Ukrainian media reports that 1 pro-Kyiv gunman was killed and 6 were wounded. Meanwhile, the Normandy 4 group met to review the Minsk agreement in Berlin on Monday. The foreign minister of Ukraine, Pavlo Klimkin, reaffirmed Ukraine's commitment to the peace accords against the backdrop of Kyiv's current military offensive in the Donbas region. Remember, the ceasefire agreement included the pullback of heavy weapons from the front line by both sides in the conflict and the establishment of a political dialogue between Kyiv and representatives of Donbas. But it seems the government in Kyiv hasn't read the document yet. Russian President Vladimir Putin repealed the self-imposed 2010 prohibition on exporting the S-300 missile system to Iran, adding a new wrinkle to US President Barack Obama and his geopolitical partners. I do think it's safe to say that Russia understands that the United States certainly takes very seriously the safety and security of our allies in the region, White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest said. Are these the allies who prefer to bomb Yemen instead of helping Iran fight the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria? Okay. According to Russian President spokesperson Dmitry Peskov, supplies of Russian S-300 air defense missile system to Iran may begin any moment in line with the relevant decree. Vladimir Putin is facing a problem few could have anticipated. The ruble is becoming too strong, Bloomberg reports. According to Bloomberg, the ruble's 14% gain this month is threatening Russia. Furthermore, a weaker ruble is the only resort for saving the Russian economy. Boom! It's a good attempt, baby. Nonetheless, we didn't forget the historical Bloomberg headlines when the ruble was falling during the past few months. Ruble falls 4-day on oil as Russia says junk rating likely. Ruble falls 2-day as Russia faces $20 billion debt repayments. And others. Ruble is rising, it's a failure of Russian economic policy. Ruble is falling, it's a failure of Russian economic policy too. Apparently, we've found a fundamental feature of popular economic analysis. Now, let's found own Bloomberg.
With blackjack and hookers.